warahmatullahi.
Eh, macam tu ke biasa kita salam? Ya ke? Pergi jumpa kawan, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Apa khabar? Itu nak ceramah. Okay, make it as informal as possible. Ada masalah? Cut. Oh. Yelah, kena cut lah. Kena reshoot, reshoot. Try to make it as informal as possible. Mana buat macam santai-santai, borak-borak santai-santai, biasa-biasa je. Okay, bismillah. Okay, can stop. Okay, action. Cut. Tak dengar suara hujung ni. Ha? Film rolling eh? Okay, yeah.
Since I hear you have anti magic, can you share a little bit about what was that? Okay, sure. The story was started on 2012, which is my mom asked me to get married with a woman.
You are a man. Oh, you have to tell the audience. And suddenly, I have to get married with a woman. How come you get married with a woman? You are a woman. Okay, tell us the story. I mean, you start with some, you know, brief introduction.
My name is Ahmad. I'm not a real name. I was 27 years old. And I was forced to get married with a woman. That was matched by my family. The story was started on 2012, which is my mom come and see me. I was a teacher at high school. My mom come and see me and my mom told me, when did you want to get married? And I said, I have my own choice, but I didn't have confidence to confess. But after that, my mom said, if like that, I want to match you with my friend's daughter, who was recently graduated from University of Malaysia. Okay.
Do you
just
accept that?
At the first time, I didn't accept because I didn't know about the woman at all. And after thinking deeply, and I accept my mom's request because I want to. Respect the decision.
Can you tell me why you choose her?
Okay, the first time I didn't ever meet the woman. And my mom came to me and gave me a photo. And I said, wow, beautiful. And I agree with my mom because I didn't, my old was 27. I didn't brave to confess at the woman that I like, and I just accept my mom's decision.
If you don't mind, can you share about the beginning of your marriage?
Okay. Actually, before our akad nikah, I was decided that I want to cancel the marriage, and I feel so bad about myself. Is it true that I want to get married? And I didn't want to get married. And then I made a phone call to the woman and I said, hello, how about you? Did you get ready to get married with me? And then the woman said to me that I had already prepared for the marriage. And then I just shut up and accept the fate of the woman. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Can you tell me the meaning of your life? Is your life?
Okay, the meaning, as you know, the marriage was so beautiful. The people who get married will be happy.
Beautiful.
Get new soulmate. But after a few months, after a few years, I had a doctor. I had a doctor for the first time on 2019, I had daughter. But after get the daughter, my wife become show her real behavior, which is actually she was daughter that was spoiled by her family. And he always keep asking me to send her to her family house every day, every week, and he doesn't want to stay with me.
How should you can stay with her? Do you have regrets after you married with her?
Actually, at the first stage, I was regret because I had work, but my mom didn't care about me at all. After we get daughter, she didn't care about me at all. I cook by myself, I wash my clothes by myself, I go to work by myself, and he keep stay at the family house. When I asked her to back at my home, he didn't want.
Okay, you're such a good person that I have never seen in my life. So I'm lucky to have someone like you. A little bit more.
After being like that, I'm trying to get closer with her. My action was success, which is we back to the normal, like the other husband and wife.
Assalamualaikum, Bu Syifa.
Waalaikumsalam.
You lawyer of the Syariah Law Society. Okay, I'm Shami. I'm student from UC. Thank you for participating me. Thank you for. Thank you for spending time with me to interview with you. Okay. Before that, I want to know your profile. Can you introduce yourself?
My name is Shifa Mesupian, and as you know, I am as a Sharia lawyer, and I have served in this position for a few years.
Okay. I had to interview with you because I carry out my assignment about pernikahan, and my topic is issues. So the task that I have given is I have to find the cases that related to issues. So, can you share with me and give me information about the issues? And are you ready to start our conversation?
Okay.
Okay. First question is, what is the meaning of the issues in the term of law, Syariah court?
In the term of law, issues, of course, and issues have. Husband issues and wife issues. Wife issues. Okay. For the term of law, a wife who can be convicted as issues must be claimed in court only, and the claim of the husband must come together with the confession of the wife herself. And the claim by the husband without the confession of the wife, the nuptials will not committed.
Okay, that means the Syariah court has priority to make a declare wife as a nuptials.
Yes,
right?
The court has the authority to declare the nuptials.
Okay. I have understand the issues perspective in the law court. Okay, my next question is, I want to focus in my real issue is about the fear of the third person. So, Washifa, you have handled the many cases of your client. Is there any cases that related to the fear of the person? I mean issues.
Yes, if I'm mistaken, I have one case about issues. It started with firstly, it started with the claim of from wife. She wanted to divorce, and she claimed the divorce, but her husband does not want to let her go. So they negotiate, and the husband made the decision. He wanted to divorce his wife by fasa.
And I want to ask you, how he hold the both party?
The couple is about the medium age. The husband is about 45 years old, and wife is 38 years old.
They have children.
They have 3 children.
Okay.
And the husband wanted to divorce his wife by fasa.
Mm-hmm.
And second, he wanted to claim wishes to his wife.
Okay. And then what is the causes that his wife become wishes?
Okay. First, during their marriage, they have married for 12 years, and for 5 years, the wife have left their house and follow the other man. Means that his wife cheating his husband.
Okay, so how the husband take the action to claim the wife become an issue? He go to the court.
Yes.
And then
he go to the court.
Mm-hmm.
And he wanted to divorce.
Mm-hmm.
His wife by fasta. About 10,000 ringgit.
Okay.
And he claimed his wife issues. And the court give the title issues to the wife.
Okay. How is the end of the cases?
If I'm not mistaken, they are officially divorced.
Okay. The last question. Can you give some advice to the new couple that want to establish a marriage?
Okay. In marriage, the one important thing is you must have the you must prepare well for the marriage, and you must prepare for the more aspects, and the most important is about the knowledge of the religion, because it may refer to the marriage is can be part of it.
Okay, I think that's all I can say. Thank you for participating in my interviews. Are you free now?
Yes.
Let's go join to a restaurant with you.
Thank you.
Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we will add for our interview with Mrs. Zuraimi, and Mutis will become Mrs. Zuraimi 2, and Alfian will become Mrs. Zuraimi 1, and I will become Mrs. Zuraimi 3. And Mutis will conclude the interview. Okay, understand? First, thank you, Mrs. Zuraimi. Because you can spend time to finish my task, our task today, for Sunday, Fikmunakahat. So, First of all, Mrs. Zurani is a teacher and she didn't give a bus for us to mention what school that she teaches. Okay, Mrs. Zurani 1. So, what is your opinion about Dori?
My opinion is Dori is most important for a marriage. But nowadays is many people not really know about the man. Why Allah say in Al-Quran about the dowry, then the lowest dowry is better for the marriage.
So
yes.
Can you give more some information from your opinion about dowry?
Okay, from the Al-Quran, said. So the conclusion is we must avoid the highest of dowry because the highest dowry can make people difficult to marriage.
So do you mean that in the Quran said the lowest dowry is the better age, and for nowadays, do you agree that the highest dowry is not relevant now?
Okay, I think the highest dowry is relevant for nowadays because we can see our economy. Our economy is very expensive.
So what about from her experience? Mrs. Zurani said she now is 35 years old. 10 years ago, she got married with her husband, and she said that before when the other party, which means her husband party, come to her parents to her parents decide to ask her husband first. What is your ability to give a dowry or to give a cost for your marriage? So she said that her parents is a very understanding person to make the marriage is for them. So she said that her parents didn't want to make any difficult thing when they want to get married. And she said that her husband didn't mean that he can give a highest dowry or he just can give a lowest dowry because since he also get a job from Honda company, since he graduated from UTP University in Porto Vera. And she said that her husband didn't have any pressure to get ready for marriage, and she said the cost for their marriage at that time is about 20,500 ringgit. Okay, so Mrs. Zurani 2, from our issue that we explained it before to you, so what is your opinion? Do you agree that men nowadays are not married because of the highest
actually I don't agree with that because we see this nowadays our country is so problem. Our economy and many crises in our country, currency. So I think they have no choice to.
What you mean they do?
A man who wants to get married, no choice to see about the height of the dowry. So I don't agree with that. And the girls want to get married. Surely, they want to be a queen. and a man become king during for ceremony. Just one day. So, no matter no what, a man must prove. But how? Must prove their love to their future couple.
Okay.
So, but how? With the dowry. So, I think no, there's no choice.
So, you mean that you don't agree with our statement?
Yes.
Our
because the ceremony is not something that we waste for our money. We put our ceremony with the best in world for our life.
For our whole life, for your
that we can show that we really, really want her to be our engineer in our life.
Okay, so you mean that it's not wrong if we spend a lot of money to make the ceremony is the best of our whole life with our future couples, because it is just for one day that we show that we really, really want her to be an angel of our life. Okay. Can you do that?
Yeah.
So, can you conclude
about this issue? I'd like to conclude this.
Okay, the conclusion is, Mrs. Remy said that nowadays people are too exposed.
They are too exposed, especially from media social.
Okay.
They do this, they say this, and we do not follow their say, what people do, what people say. We must open mind before we make a decision. Create our moment, moment in our life, in our ceremony of marriage, and that we can afford. We can provide the cost, so not to be much, but enough for what we can afford. So we can make a moment in our life for one day. So,
okay. So Mrs. Zulani says that people nowadays are very exposed to media social, because too many lot of people, they do what other people do. They see that this ceremony is very, very, very what? Very grand. And they say that they want. But when they think that their economy, their salary, their ability to spend money, they didn't can to do it. But Mrs. Remy said, now we must look overall of which is our crisis economy, so our couple also. She mean that we must know the ability of the man, who is the person that spend his time, his money and his energy to fulfill the cost of your marriage. Thank you very much.
Assalamualaikum sir, and good morning.
Waalaikumsalam.
How are you today?
I'm fine.
I'm sharing today. Actually today I'm here to make some interview with you to complete my task under topic FASA. Before we start our interview, can you introduce yourself?
Okay, I'm Cik Yunus bin Ismail, and I'm 36 years old. I'm a Syariah lawyer, and I've been a lawyer almost 12 years.
Okay, thank you, sir. Can we start our interview now?
Okay, sure.
Okay, my first question is, what is the definition? What is the definition of fasa?
Okay, the definition of fasa is the dissolution of marriage, which is a husband and wife bring the matter to the court to claim fasa. Okay, what's mean the matter? Okay, means that you need to bring the strong evidence from police report and criminal report.
That means someone who wants to claim fasa need a reason and any evidence to prove the reason.
Yeah, you need to bring the evidence, because if you don't have the evidence, you can't proceed the fasa. It's quite difficult, okay?
Okay, thank you sir for your answer. Can we continue our interview? Okay, if you don't mind, can you share with me the case which is related to fasa?
Okay, actually this is privacy because it's between me and my client, but it's okay. I will share with you one of the cases, which is the husband claim the fasa. Okay. The partners work as a doctor. Okay. The age of the partner is around 40 years, and they already have 4 children. The duration of their marriage is 10 years, and the fact issue is the wife act hard against husbands.
That means in their marriage there is domestic abuse in their marriage.
Yeah.
Can you give an example?
Okay. The problem is start with the wife. When she feel angry, she will hurt her husband. Okay. The husband always being hurt at the back of his body and make a left mark impact of beaten. But the husband still patient and almost 10 years he keep patient with his wife beaten.
The husband keep patient until 10 years old, 10 years with his wife behavior.
Yes.
Maybe there is some reason why the husband can be patient with his wife behavior.
Okay. The reason why the husband still patient with his wife is because he really love his wife. Okay, he tried to save their marriage, and at the same time he want to keep the reputation of their professional work. And he assume that if he make a report about his wife, it will bring his ego down as a man.
So what is the end of the case?
Okay, the end of this case. The husband cannot pay of physical abuse, so he decide to collect all the evidence and make a report. And finally, the husband decide to split with his wife.
Okay, thank you, sir, for your time for this interview.
Okay, alhamdulillah.
Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nisha Nira Binti Fadil Ahmed.
My name is Raja Nisha Binti Fadil Ahmed.
We will act on what we have
interview
on Ustaz Aris and my team. Assalamualaikum Ustaz. My name is Nisha Yazid Khalil Ahmed. I from UC Sun Islam Malaysia. I have a task that has given by my lecturer. We must do some research on the topic of Nafaka. So I come to this court to ask you about the Nafaka. Can you sorry for interrupt, can Ustaz explain what the cases that you have handled in the
so about Nafaka, there is so many cases that related to Nafaka, which is has two actually, Nafaka wife and Nafaka for child. So do you want to know Nafaka wife or Nafaka child?
Nafaka for children.
Nafaka for children, okay. So the cases are courts are in support. There is so many cases that related to Nafaka of the children, which is have in 2016 have 37 cases actually, and in this year have 21 cases at Sempak only, not all Selangor. And then the cases that I have handled, one of them is cases the defendant is Sharifah Aida Mazli binti Harafi and Azmin Hatta. His former husband.
Can you explain more?
Ah, yes. So for make simple and make it more understand. Firstly, the defendant came to mahkamah and sued the defendant, which is his former husband. That she want to after divorce, she want to sue his son, sue his husband to pay maintenance for their children, which is his children is like 2 months something at that time, but his husband doesn't give a proper and
his husband.
Her husband not give a proper maintenance to his children, which is at that time her husband just give a 750 ringgit per month only. So she, Sharifah Aida Mazli, want to upgrade the maintenance to 1,500 ringgit per month.
Can I know what the section of the maintenance?
So the section is 73 year 2003.
Okay, so that from the case that you have tell me, what is the stage that the procedure that Sharifah will do with her husband?
Oh, so the other step is for nafkah to their children. Actually, in court, we advise them to join that solo council to take an advice or something to make their like that actually. At solo council, that two parties is actually agree to with the defendant is agree with the plaintiff decision that that she want to.
Okay. So can I know what the case of claim
Case of claim, firstly on 12 October 2016,
At that time, the judge is J. Abdullah J. Hassan, and Elimas, and the defendant come with lawyer Sharani, who is Siti Faiza and Nazira. And at that time, they do open court. They open court.
From that, can I know the summary of decision got to the advancement and her former sentence?
So, the summary is the judgment sulung. Judgment sulung, which is her husband is agreed with all the decision that that made by the court, which is 52+1. And amal by Syariah, so that her husband is agreed to give a maintenance, which is he upgrade from 750 per month to 1,500 per month, and also expenses for Hari Raya.
So meaning that her former husband must give to their children the name of Putri Zahra. 1,015 for every year in the Hari Raya Fitri.
Yes.
So the place that she and her former husband give the money at the mahkamah or just bank?
No, just bank in. The defendant is give the money to a mahkamah and go through to the defendant, Sharifah Aida Mazlum.
Ustaz, thank you for the explanation. Can Ustaz bring me to see the file of cases that have at the court?
So you can see at the file case, you will see a 024 number, the code that is related to nafkah.
Can I ask you to see all the cases?
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Ustaz.
Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today, we will present about Syndicate of Marriage. On 9 October, Tuesday, we got interview Dr. Ustaz Aris Fadila bin Ramli, ex-coordinator.
Use the wali raja who did not get the credential and recognition.
discuss this right now. Second question, can you give statistics in Malaysia about this case?
Okay. In 2015, the statistic of the of this marriage is 1,708, and then in 2016, it increased to 736. Okay.
1,736. That 1 year? Which year was that?
2016.
1,000? 1,000?
1,000? the couple know or not they use the syndicate. Usually most of the case that happen, they don't know that the marriage use, they don't know that they use the syndicate of marriage.
When they know the syndicate?
When they want to register the marriage, at that time that they will know.
Or register in the court, at the court and they know that their marriage is invalid. Okay, what the effect? From what the effect if they use the syndicate?
Okay. First of all, I want to say based on the case. When they use that syndicate of marriage, it's because the woman don't have the permission from his parents. The most important is his father, her father. Okay. And it's because from that case also, the woman still studies at one of the local university in Malaysia. Okay.
I ask you about the effect, not the case, the kids. effect, the same effect.
Okay. The effects. When they use this marriage, the marriage is not valid, and they have to register it.
Okay. Last question. What the solution? What's the solution? To avoid this situation?
Okay. What the
solution?
The solution is they have to know the knowledge in
we must know to both in religious, hukum syar'i and in legal.
Go to the court and appeal to Fasah, Jasper. So, Jasper see by the second test if she did not divorce, she will maybe become suffer longer from the blackmail. So the judge take the girl and set it, and the husband fast goodbye.
Thank you for
answering.
Something to do.
What?
I am pregnant.
Pregnant?
Yes.
Whose child is it? Tell me.
You cheated behind me?
No.
So?
You cheated behind me?
How dare you? Go to the hell.
See you.
This is for interview session.
My name
At the same time at the court. Then
Then I forgot, Hadona is wife.
For me.
Then husband, I don't know, whatever of that after that.
So how you survive after your cerai?
After cerai, I'm so sad. I cannot say anything.
Thank you for giving me permission. We hope to see you well in your child.
Okay, inshallah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Okay. Now we see some action, eh?
Yes.
Very good. Very good.